Commentating is very, very fun. I enjoy it a lot. Obviously, watching even like I feel like your love for commentary will also kind of be cross-referenced with like the region you're into, right? I think SoCal is a really sick region. There's so many like talented players, so really it's an honor to like commentate their gameplay as well. And well, speaking of honor
and talented players, we got Charlie now on screen.
Yes,
talented elegant. Here in our losers final section.
Yeah, and this is a tale as old as time at this point. You know, so goodness. Well,
The next note I was gonna say is that Charlie describes fighting Luigi very positively from my knowledge and experience hearing him talk about it, but Elegant made sure to dunk on him to start things off and set the tone.
Yeah, I mean, even just some history, when Charlie played Fox in Smash 4, and a lot of Fox has thought that Luigi Fox was like horrible for Fox. Charlie was one of the few people that believed that it wasn't that bad. You know what I mean? And just played that matchup all the time. No double jump, the flash goes high, and Elegant not able to pick it up with a back air.
You know, Elegant really wanted that stock right there. He was just a little bit off.
Yeah. So yeah, Charlie definitely very experienced in this matchup for sure. But right now, not looking too experienced because Elegant. Now Charlie is the one that put Elegant into losers, I believed, and I was on the side playing some friendlies. I caught a couple glimpses of that set, and I got to tell you, man, Charlie was
Charlie was playing good
in that last
set. Rearing back in his seat, he's like, I gotta get back into this. He's like, you're up a stock.
84%, man, and that is not the KO, but that is a ton of damage, and Charlie is on his last stock as well.
All right, Charlie. Oh, that was just a reset ledge, effectively.
Yeah. And well, the great thing about that, too, is like landing and sliding off is you get your double jump back as well. So very, very good there. Charlie gets the ledge jump, but doesn't capitalize too fast.
Elegant is not able to punish the grab whiff there, and kind of we get another reset. Good patience by Elegant, and he strikes while the iron is hot. Big F smash instead. Game one.
Yeah, I mean, and that up smash isn't necessarily bad right there. It catches a lot of options. You know what I mean? It can catch, jump's probably like the more like common thing you're going for on that read. But like you said, the patience coming out from Elegant, that shield discipline is so, so important. And, you know, he was getting grabbed up earlier too, but just kind of stayed in the shield, waited, and just got that punish. Kind of felt like Charlie was, kind of getting like fishing for the kill there. And he just really good patience from Elegant.
All right, game two, back on FD.
Yeah, I mean, and we commentated so much like PS2 and Battlefield, so.
Yeah, it's kind of nice to see some difference.
Yeah, and FD is a very straightforward stage. Like once somebody has advantage, it's like it can be really rough on FD. There's no like outside forces to help you reset your resources, right? Like there's just the flat stage. There's no platform, you know what I mean? Like there's nothing to reset your double jump on. It's just you got to get to the ground, or you're going.
The only weird, even borderline sneaky meta is if you decide to like play a character with a primarily red and black color scheme. He's gonna get super obscure during some of the
camouflage
portions.
Tech. Uppy?
Yeah.
Okay. I feel like in those like wait a minute.
Oh, this ledge trap. Is it gonna go anywhere? Oh, not quite yet.
Yeah, and we're starting to see the down tilts coming out from Elegant. Something we didn't see too much versus Lucina. Obviously, Lucina's up B is very hard to contest to the ledge. So, you know, one of the bigger reasons why Elegant, we didn't see too much down tilt in the last matchup. Okay, doesn't get stuck on the stage. You don't want to misfire too close to the stage.
No, he ran right into that back throw and...
living.
Charlie almost got completely rope-a-dope there trying to go for the kill. Yeah, a little too greedy.
Yeah, but that was really good on Charlie, not doing any panic air dodge. Like, this is where you see the experience even through. It's like, okay, like, you hit that. I'm not going to be all, like, worried or anything. Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
But the offstage. Yeah. Elegant has been really nailing it. No rage in the tank, which means that back throw not going to be quite it. The dash attack.
The dash attack well.
Elegant even tried to do the slide off there, but very, very well-timed whiff punish from Charlie. I like the up tilts.
Oh, Elegant, they punished just for sliding back and trying to get the grab. Excellent shield grab, but the mash from Elegant. I mean, if you know one thing about Elegant, is that the man subjects controllers to a lot of abuse when it comes to mashing.
Whew, this ledge trapping from Charlie is so clean. I love that down smash. Didn't charge it or anything, and then just saw the normal get up and was able to get the punish right there. Wolf has so many threats to get you off the ledge. Charlie is he hasn't hit him off the ledge yet, but he's showing that he's willing to use them. So he's really controlling the tempo in which Elegant's picking these ledge options.
Oh, excellent dash grab there from Charlie. Putting Elegant up and making him pay.
Advantage state, the stage. Welcome to Final Destination. Charlie got one hit and did not let Elegant go.
Absolutely the most volatile stage in the stage format.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the plunger was still there, but Charlie able to Wolf flash his way back on stage, almost avoiding a very early gimp.
Elegant.
Elegant almost named Charlie a second time with Dare off stage.
Okay, gonna live there.
Can Charlie land?
Up smash? No, the jab. Got the up smash. A little later.
I mean, to be fair, Charlie's been like almost instant jumping the minute he gets back on stage to avoid Elegant's like step back grabs. So instead, Elegant was like, I'm gonna key in on that dash and up smash. That's essentially the mix up there.
I like that rising cyclone. That one's a bit risky just because you were double jumping and cycloning. You leave yourself extremely open, but you know, mixing it in can definitely throw your opponent in a loop there, and we just saw that earlier. But right now, Charlie in the driver's seat. Forward tilt, not enough. If that blaster connected, that would have been so huge. It would have stopped all of Elegant's horizontal momentum. Gets the air dodge.
Oh, but instead Charlie was waiting for it, lying in wait with that down smash. That's going to do it for...
For a moment, I thought Charlie was going to, because he didn't commit to anything. I saw the air dodge, and I was like, you got it. And then, he got the upside. I was like, okay. Like, really good positioning. You got it, though. You got it.
Charlie was like, watch this.
No, yeah, just really good positioning, too, because, right there you see the air dodge, but you want to make sure you catch, a directional air dodge, too, right? So Charlie just fast fell back onto the ground, and he just had to confirm, it was a neutral, it's drifting this. Okay, boom, up smash, right? You don't want to get too, hasty on the punish, essentially. Ooh, okay. Okay, we got a big opener here.
I love it when we see the reflector combos from Charlie. He's the only Wolf who just absolutely mixes that in all the time in his low percentage game.
Yeah, he took a couple hits from the side B there. But even off stage, sometimes you can gimp. Actually, a lot of times you can gimp Luigi just by getting hit on purpose. Obviously, the only thing you don't want to get hit by is a misfire at kill percent. But
Charlie, with another veteran move there, a lot of younger players probably would have been completely hosed by the tornado, but he was able to slip down and get back up.
Yeah.
That
said,
Elegant cleaning up his mistakes, taking the stock, and Charlie likewise. Wolf, big back air.
Wolf back air.
Back
that
air
move.
is a crime against humanity, man.
That move is never been nerfed. Yeah, Wolf back air still is out here, just deleting stocks. You can combo into that move, by the way. Oh, man.
Elegant has to be a little careful about how much shield he's holding. Oh!
No jab lock. Yeah, if Elegant may be just more confident that Charlie was going to hit the tech there, but if you jab lock there as Luigi, you get a stock with the up. Okay.
Nice.
Into the cyclone.
Oh, he caught the ears! He just basically caught the tippy top of Wolf's hurt box with that tornado and just eat him to the skies.
Yeah. And right there's no rage, so maybe Charlie could have lived, but the DI got crossed up there. It can be a little difficult, kind of similar to something like Rob up air in terms of DIing, right? You really have to understand which side you are on the move, and you can kind of help that out with SDI and stuff like that. Oh man, that Wolf forward tilt not connecting. Definitely one of the moves that sometimes don't fully connect because they're so far away, right?
Yeah, okay. Elegant finally managed to get back to center stage, but Charlie pushed him back to the other side of the stage.
Ooh, that drift back there was so safe.
Big dash attack. Almost tempted to the laser for once, but Elegant recognized the situation, air dodge. Charlie put him up high. Can Elegant land?
Oh,
he tornadoes right as soon as you saw that signaling for the smash attack.
Okay. That move has so much lag.
Charlie
Jeez.
Whiffing that dash attack had him checking his own controller for a second to see if there was something wrong.
Yeah. Probably wanted a dash up smash, but got dash attack instead. All right, so Charlie, the gun is out. Okay, I like these safe fares. Elegant finds the opening.
Does this lead insurmountable for Charlie?
Nah, definitely playing a very broken character right now, Wolf.
He was ready.
You don't die to that. At ground level, that move is strong, but if you DI it correctly, you live like much, much longer. Oh, okay, you might be gone.
Not that time.
All right, so Elegant gonna close it out. Sigh of relief here. And Elegant knows, like, Charlie still could have won that game, right?
Yeah.
Like, it Elegant was very, very patient with the ledge trapping, just really waited, understood when Charlie wanted to pick an option, and was able to pick up these KOs, the double cyclone at the end. I'm going to close it out.
He's just extra precise with the plunger there towards the end. I just showing his, like, very, you know, high-level play with the character. He's just not over-relying on the plunger with a lot of mid-level moves as well.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so Elegant is up 2-1 here against Charlie. Charlie running it right back to Final Destination. Border connects. Tech Chase tries to get a roll in there. So, you know, the great thing about Wolf is you get very solid damage, and usually after you get some kind of tech chase, which can lead to, you know, even more damage, can get very, very snowball-y. Double meaty.
That Nair there just after capturing Elegant in a bad place. But Elegant, right now, ran into the grab. Charlie was ready, but Elegant was ready as well. The tornado, Charlie pushing Elegant off stage, the big F tilt.
And Charlie's just timing these forward tilts. Wow, what a mash out of the grab there.
Yeah.
That's pretty impressive for being at, like, the percentage he was at.
Right.
Charlie with the fast one to up B. Should it be enough?
Oh,
but you
it
got
is.
The cross up the eye. In that situation, you can hold down and not, like, you can probably live. Because in there, that situation, Charlie died because he got crossed up, right?
And that time, Charlie was able to catch Elgin before he slipped off stage with the tornado. Big dash attack for the kill.
Oh, I love the patience there. That second hard nair, you know, pretty much catching that spot dodge. Charlie just, like, kind of floating around and waiting.
Oh, Elgin sensed he was about to get comboed again. Again, get out a free card, tornado.
Ooh, again.
Charlie's just been a little short with some of his wolf flashes against Elegant, and I think it probably says a lot more about Elegant than it does against, say, about Charlie's whiffing them. Like, he's just mindful of that possibility and just playing defensively well, DIing well.
Oh, yeah. It can be hard sometimes to DI, you know, some of the lower hitting aerials, so most players don't DI the wolf falling fair particularly well, but if you do, it can be really rough for Wolf to get some.
Speaking of really rough right now, this is a particularly rough situation for Elegant.
Yeah, kind of getting a little greedy there. To be fair, Elegant hasn't really gone for that the whole entire set, so the fact that Charlie was ready for that definitely might not hit right the right way. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but,
absolutely.
I mean, all Charlie did was run up forward and shield, right? Probably didn't even really expect that particular option, just a very common option that's just gonna be good.
The other thing is I really feel like Charlie's got a good sense of what Elegant wants to punish his shield or hit his shield. Because as soon as Elegant just, like, rides an aerial or tries to plunge around shield, he's ready!
I thought I was so sure that Charlie was gonna go for, like, a hard nair into, like, a spike flash. But doesn't go for the tech.
Tech test passed.
Yeah, really good stuff.
Oh, double tornado on the ground, but still, again, at 155, Charlie 11, just like what you just said, Charles. But that one's gonna do it.
And it can be really tricky with, in terms of DIing it, because especially on the ground, Elegant can, like, move forward really quick or move forward, like, kind of slow, and it can be really ambiguous in terms of, like, the DI cross-up. All right, let's see if Charlie can get this ledge trap, gets the corner situation, gets the roll in. Okay.
Looking a little rough for Elegant, but he does survive to go back to center stage. Oh, look at this. He's just terrified in shield right now.
That cross-up neutral air dodge was so good from Charlie. Oh, the pivot grab, the uppie.
Oh, man. Elegant tried to steal it.
Yeah.
Oh,
man. Elegant definitely just tried to just end the game right there. That's all I'll say about that. But it was a little harder. He had a bunch of rage. When Luigi has rage, the down throw, especially when DI correctly, it can be pretty tough, right, to get some of these conversions. But nonetheless, I've definitely seen Elegant hit those. So definitely a reason. There was a reason for Elegant going for that, right?
Charlie was just prepared in the end.
Yeah.
That's all you could say about that one.
All right, so game five. Yes, we are running it back.
All FD set.
Yep.
Hey, I like that view sometimes.
Yeah, true.
Maybe when I'm spectating at home on Twitch. By the way, thanks everybody in Twitch chat for stopping by. If you haven't done so yet, drop a follow.
You
help support 2G Gaming.
Hell yeah. Every Monday, we're out here. Players are out here. Okay, down B here, and whoever... So, here is the down throw.
That's gonna do it.
There's the down throw up B. Very, very good. A lot more consistent, as you can see, with the lower amount of rage. They're 63% on Elegant. Charlie striking back, though, getting the back air.
Oh, wow.
That was such a good bait on the get-up attack. You saw Charlie, like, not have his shield up, and at the very last moment brought up his shield. So very excellent bait. Didn't get the punish, unfortunately, though.
Oh, wait, damn, but this time it's Elegant who's ready for the shield.
Yeah.
Oh, good tech roll in by Elegant. He's ready to play defensively. Can't do much about fair when, you know, Wolf's air drift allows him to get that back air. And now, Elegant, deep down, he's got to get a misfire, I think, right now. Oh, nope. Not quite.
So whenever Luigi wants to extend the recovery, in that situation, you double jump with the side B. So that was like a scenario where Charlie could have got hit by that side B particularly because he had to double jump side B. You get hit by that side B on purpose and you just like, he can't make it back, right? There's nothing left to go horizontal.
Yeah, a little more luck with the laser, but not quite that much knockback. I was able to get back to stage and take center stage. Ooh, I do like the aggressiveness with like the step forward F smash, but Charlie was ready for it.
Oh no, Charlie off stage here. The plunger does catch the double jump and
fair.
The slap. Beautifully executed edgeguard, and Elegant is sitting at 186% right now.
This entire game has gone according to Elegant's rhythm. He's going to suffer that wolf flash, but...
The YOLO wolf flash. Sometimes desperate times call for desperate measures, right?
Exactly.
He doesn't want to grab.
So Charles, if you're like when you're in this kind of situation where it's just like, oh, I've finally barely gotten in, but man, it's a high mountain to climb. What do you have to tell yourself? What do you have to tell yourself if you're like in Charlie's position?
You have to have a lot of faith in your neutral and advantage state. If you want to win, then you have to go into the rest of the game and
I think he wasn't ready to up B. And Elegant, after playing masterfully, big show of emotion here in the room. And we have the crowd clapping.
You gotta give it up.
We like to see a show.